morning, everyone. I know there was an issue about us not being in the council chambers during the summer. That is not the case. Seems like we've been here every week. All right, let's get serious. Let's get serious. First of all, thank everyone for being here today. We have a relatively brief message. We just would like to formalize an issue that we've been talking about for pretty much the last couple of weeks since Dr. Height has referenced the sense of urgency required as it relates to the $50 million. 2 days ago, we forwarded informally a proposal to Dr. Height that references property sales. The list of properties estimated to be approximately $200 million that is currently in the school district's public surplus inventory is something that we think that should be in play. Since that conversation, the public sentiment seems to be that if you have significant assets in a crisis, you need to utilize those assets. That can solve a whole lot of problems. As I said earlier, one, providing short-term significant revenue to the school district, two, dealing with currently vacant and blighted properties within these neighborhoods, and the long-term benefits of those buildings actually being functional. Some of them would actually be for-profit development opportunities that would generate significant tax revenue as a result of the ongoing activity in those buildings. The document that we have forwarded to Dr. Height, and we will provide the kit to you, essentially lays out the following. City Council would approve a transfer ordinance to move $50 million in general fund receipts to the appropriate city department. Pursuant to an agreement, the funds would then be transferred to the Philadelphia Authority for Industrial Development, which is traditionally the organization that we use when we want to do substantive and substantial property transactions, be it sale or disposition. We would ask that the entire portfolio of the school district be funneled over to Paid for purchase of sale. Per the agreement, Paid market and dispose of the properties at fair market value. After each closing, Paid will disperse the sales proceeds to the city. Upon the completion of the first $50 million in sale, the contractual relationship between Paid and the City of Philadelphia will be terminated, i.e., we will get the $50 million back that we have given to the school district for short-term funding. The additional acquisitions and dispositions, what we anticipate will be substantial, shall go directly to the school district. Under this agreement, Paid will either continue to market and sell those properties on behalf of the school district, or if the school district determines that they would like to opt out of that particular provision, they have the jurisdiction and the right to do that. It is clear based on the most recent activity with respect to the school district, ability to market and sell property has been, let me say that it hasn't been at the level that we all would like, including the school district. And I understand because their primary focus should be and continues to be educating children. So I think this is the best strategy for all of us to allow Paid, who has been a very good marketer of properties and a very good disposition agency. As we move ahead, we clearly want to talk about some longer-term strategies. But before I get to that, I would like to talk about this notion that we've heard referenced from several sources, not a whole lot, but some sources about the concerns about the ability for these properties to be sold. Councilwoman Blackwell actually has a list of properties here that through our investigation, because as a legislative body, what we have to do is to talk to all the members and get a sense of whether or not this particular proposal will work. These lists of properties, based on office of property assessment values and appraisals, far exceed the $50 million. I would like to reference them, but at this point I would not feel comfortable with distributing those properties to the public because there are requests from private sector interests to the school district. But trust me, they're here. Can show them maybe, but not distribute them in the public. So with respect to any notion that somehow these properties won't sell, that's just not the case. There are clearly people who are interested, people who have attempted to acquire, but not been in a position to do that. We think having Paid involved in this process will allow us to expeditiously move forward and provide short-term significant cash to the school district and clear up the carrying costs that are around $1.8 million currently for the school district to lift that burden from their hands and allow them to take on their mission, which is educating young people. Yes, sir.
The mayor this morning assured the superintendent that he will get the $50 million, the schools will open on time, and that he will borrow this one way or another. What's your reaction to that?
Well, our reaction is that this has been forwarded to the superintendent. This is a formal submission in a very public way that we will assure the superintendent that they will get 50. The 50 that we're talking about does not include a borrowing, which to a significant degree concerns us. And the school district has recently borrowed $300 million, paying a $22 million a year. They were in a position where they had no other option. We would not like to see the school district, or in this case, the city of Philadelphia, be in any more debt if it's not needed. Our proposal calls for a straight conveyance, transfer of dollars to pay subsequently to the school district that will not include a borrowing, thereby saving the city and the school district $10 million of interest payments on the particular borrowing that was referenced by the mayor.
Sure. This floor and the second floor are still at odds over how to get the $50 million. How do you feel about the mayor offering an assurance to Height that that $50 million will come, regardless of the mayor?
Well, the mayor's assurance requires a number of things based on what I'm told he said. And this is not new. The mayor has been consistently attempting to get us to sign on to a proposal that was brokered at the last minute in the state without anybody on this particular podium being in the room. In my understanding, not a single member of the Philadelphia House delegation in the room. So with respect to that particular agreement that was reached, I don't think it's appropriate to reach an agreement and now come to the body without further input into whatever long-term agreement that means, short-term, long-term. We clearly do not support a borrowing, but let me tell you what we do support. We do support the extension of the 1% sales tax in fiscal 14 to go towards a long-term solution for schools and funding. We have submitted a plan on several occasions that incorporates the long-term solutions that approximates $200 million based on cigarettes, based on sales tax, based on the revenues that are generated by the city, which, by the way, is the only money in the deal currently, the city money. So we're very comfortable with our position with respect to providing revenues through the sales tax. As you all know, we consistently said that there should be a split on sales tax between schools and between the pensions. We have to solve our pension problem, and we obviously also have to come up with a long-term funding solution.
You are not supporting what the mayor put forward this morning.
No.
You will not authorize that or see that council authorize.
Council will support and has an ordinance that reflects our position on the long-term solutions with respect to funding for school.
$50 million borrowing,
we do not support the $50 million borrowing. We do not support the $50 million borrowing. Can't have $2 million in real estate available. It's $200 million in real estate available, right, for sale, and you go out and borrow $50 million. I mean, this is from a fiscal perspective, just to me, doesn't make a lot of sense. I don't think I understand your question.
Can you get the money by tomorrow?
Well, there's no plan out there where $50 million could be delivered tomorrow.
But the certification that Height requested and requires to open the schools.
Dr. Height has asked us to, he actually asked for a letter with city council, right, committing a proposal that will put $50 million on the table. Absolutely. We've already done it. We've already done it. He's asked for a commitment from City Council for a $50 million plan. We have done that. There is no proposal out there, our proposal, nor the mayor's proposal, that can deliver $50 million tomorrow. Dr. Height has said he does not need $50 million tomorrow. He needs a commitment for $50 million to allow the continuation of the school year.
Dr. Height said that this idea of selling off school property, that's already a part of their five-year plan. So how do you all work with him to get him on board to allow the city to sell off these properties?
One thing about city council, we work with our stakeholders, and we have been in conversations with the school district with respect to the property proposal. So this is not something that he's hearing about today. So we're currently working with them to address any concerns that they have. They talked about the $28 million that is currently in the five-year plan. That $28 million is in a five-year plan. It does not indicate at what point the $28 million will be needed. Our plan calls for more than the 28 and has the opportunity to provide upwards of more than $200 million in surplus real estate. The challenge with the school district is one, their inability to sell surplus real estate. And we think we have a solution that will not only get them the 28, but get them a whole lot more than the 28, and we'll get it to them soon.
I'm
not uncertain at all.
You have another plan that says going off unused property. What is Dr. Height to believe? Is he assured that this money is
coming? I talk to Dr. Height pretty much every day. So we're in constant conversation with Dr. Height about our proposal. And we have been working with him on this. He has indicated that he needs to get rid of surplus real estate and get that revenue. We laid out a plan and a structure that will not only allow him to meet his $28 million goal in short term, but also significantly more revenue to the school district and the city of Philadelphia, and a path to get upwards of $200 million of much-needed revenue to the school district over the next couple of years.
President Clarke, your plan requires administration action. The mayor's plan requires council approval. Neither of you seem willing to grant that. Tomorrow's the deadline. Will schools open on September 9th?
Tomorrow's the deadline for a plan. I'm saying that Dr. Height has asked for a commitment. We have given Dr. Height a commitment. We will do it in a public way. We have done that a couple of days ago with a letter supported by the members of council. The mayor's plan, my understanding, calls for a vote of council for an extension of a 1% sales tax, but it also includes a borrowing which members do not support, particularly. We'll wait until that particular time.
But do you think it's responsible?
I don't want to speculate on the potential disagreement. The reality is, the mayor has said that he did not agree with the provision, the proposal that was put forth by the governor that required all of the revenue from sales to go to schools. He said that he would have liked to have seen a reasonable split. But the mayor has apparently signed on to that deal. City Council is not comfortable with that particular proposal, and we've indicated time after time there should be a reasonable split, and most importantly, everybody who are, all of the members of both the local council, the Philly state and house delegation, and the mayor and the governor's people need to be in the room when whatever deal is crafted. I just don't think it's appropriate for a deal to be crafted when the majority of the people who represent the city of Philadelphia are not privy to that conversation, particularly given the fact that at the end of the day, this group of members here will be asked to pass the legislation that appropriates the revenue both short and long term.
Do you think it was presumptuous of the mayor to announce what he did this morning, that the superintendent would go ahead and count on that $50 million given the lack of agreement?
Hey, I'm not going to tell you what I really think.
Yeah, come on.
Because it would not be productive.
Can you tell us why?
We have a proposal. You probably had all 17 members of City Council supporting this proposal. I'll leave it there.
The mayor said he's going to borrow this money.
whether you pass the sales tax extension or not, and then if you don't, then the general fund will be on the hook for paying it back. But doesn't doing this now give you the opportunity to then spend the rest of the fiscal year negotiating in Harrisburg to get the kind of split that you want on that to get maybe the cigarette tax? I mean, why be opposed to borrowing?
You should be a member of council or a member of the mayor's cabinet. That is exactly what we have said, that we need to fix the short-term solution, which is the $50 million. We have a way of doing that without borrowing money and going in debt and costing both the city and the school district additional dollars. That $10 million in interest payments, I much rather put that in the school district's hand. And then give us an opportunity to discuss with the General Assembly and the Governor's Office over the fall about a solution. I've been told that by the General Assembly and other individuals that this notion about cigarette tax is not dead at this point. That's a significant amount of revenue that can go to schools. I would like to have, obviously, our members' ability to be in the conversation with those parties as we craft some long-term solution. So we're simply saying that there's a way of fixing the short-term issue without borrowing $50 million. It solves several problems, as I've said. Let's get this done, and then let's allow us to have an opportunity to talk through the longer-term issues with respect to funding for schools.
Real quick, here, Mike. Do you think you can pass the transfer ordinance with a veto proof, because the mayor's people have made it absolutely clear they don't want all these school buildings on their books?
I mean, we'll deal with that at the appropriate time.
To clarify your plan, just so everybody understands, the $50 million would come from where in your plan? It's fronted to the school district.
Yeah, we currently have, for this fiscal year, a surplus, and it's rather hefty. But be clear that in our out years, our fund balance will go down. Two things. One, we're very comfortable with respect to our ability to sell the schools. As I've indicated, Councilwoman Blackwell has in her hand a list of developers and other entities who have expressed an interest in purchasing a school. We'll get the $50 million back. Let me finish, please. In addition to which, this notion that there's some concerns about the five-year plan that was submitted to PICA includes, I think, more than $150 million wage tax cuts that were not authorized by the City Council of Philadelphia. So that impacts significantly the five-year plan issue.
$50 million comes from the city coffers.
Yes.
Money that you have in surplus.
Yes.
And you believe that within the fiscal year you will be able to sell the property that you become title holder to, and that will more than cover that $50 million.
The $50 million, I don't want to commit to the sales in 1 year, although I believe it'll happen. But I don't want to commit to the sales in 1 year. But the reality is, if the concern is a five-year plan, I don't know how you can't be in a position to spread $50 million out over a five-year plan. I don't think it's an issue because the properties will sell. Because there is going to be a time when the sales tax burns down, basically terminates us with respect to going to the City of Philadelphia. We will have a tick down with respect to the City of Philadelphia's revenue. But one, I'm comfortable. Two, with respect to the long-term viability of the five-year plan, based on the submission that includes more than $150 million in tax cuts, is just not something that's law.
In your discussions with Dr. Heisen, has he been comfortable?
Right. Right.
In your discussions with Dr. Heisen, has he been comfortable with your proposition?
Well, you know, Dr. Heisen will respond. After this, because we've been talking, you know, I told him that we were going to do this, and he will respond, I'm assuming, to you all with respect to our proposal, but he is aware of it. Our staff have been working on this proposal, so I'll let Dr. Hite respond himself.
Given where things stand now, what, in your view, is going to happen on September 9th?
I think the schools will open.
With the guarantee of what? Which $50 million? You and the mayor.
I mean, that's not. We were asked to do something, right? In a very public way by a lot of people in this room, outside of this room, up on 400 North Broad. And we have responded to that request with a proposal that makes all of the sense in the world, which is 50 plus. So With respect to the request and with respect to the opening of schools on the 9th, I think that we've met that particular request in a very meaningful way.
Weren't you asked to get the $50 million, not to have a plan or a proposal for the $50 million?
You were in the room, sir. You know what the ask was. The ask was a signal or a letter from City Council. We have given a plan supported by significant documents with respect to the ability to market and sell these properties. We weren't asked to say, give us a $50 million check. We were asked for a signal that council will provide support for a plan that will give them $50 million. And we've given them a plan that will do that.
Can you talk about your plan that lays out the split? At some point, will it all go to pension? Or at what point will you phase out the split?
Well, I don't want to get into some of the challenges with respect to the existing legislation in Harrisburg. Lost in some of this is the reality that the legislation that was passed in Harrisburg must be revisited because there were two issues in there. One was the structure of the repayment of the debt service, and two was the fact that it didn't include a maintenance of effort relief component in that bill. My understanding, based on my conversation with Harrisburg and people from the business community and others, it was always anticipated that the maintenance of effort provision would be put in the bill. So we fully anticipate that that bill will be amended in September or, you know, sometimes in the fall. So we can't actually enact that until the maintenance of effort issue is available for us.
So do you think that Dr. Height has the final choice?
I'm simply saying that we were asked to do something, and we did it. I mean, they asked for a proposal for $50 million in a commitment. We have done that.
So council will go forward with, I'm assuming it sounds like the support of the legislation to buy up and sell off these unused properties. And it will go to the mayor. And the mayor will probably veto it because he wants to borrow the money. But then you guys can override that.
I don't want to speculate on what happens down the line.
Well, I mean, it sounds to me like you all have the upper hand.
I don't think my response would be productive. We're a very focused group. I mean, and we work in an extremely collaborative way. I mean, you can't have 17 members of council and come to a consensus on anything unless you work together, which is what we are about. We have worked with members of the General Assembly. Saw us at the press conference the other day on the 45. Consistently over the last 2 years, this council has worked with everybody. We wouldn't have gotten through ABI, which earlier this year was actually the big subject matter. But we moved through that process in a relatively smooth transition because we worked together. So we're consistent. We're on board with our proposal, and hopefully we will move forward.
Council President, do you think it's responsible for Superintendent Height at this point to proceed as though that $50 million is going to happen regardless of the mechanism and go ahead with plans to open the school? Is that responsible?
I'm very supportive of Dr. Height. I'm sure a number of other members here, if not all. I think he knows what he's doing. So if he has asked us to provide something, we have provided it, and he feels comfortable with that to proceed then.
Well, the mayor in his communication today said he recommended to the superintendent that he should go ahead and begin the rehiring process. Would you go on the record and say the same?
I'm going on the record and saying I'm responding to Dr. Height's request. I mean, you know, he doesn't attempt to tell me what to do, and I'm not going to tell him what to do. But he has asked us for something, and we've provided him with what he asked us for.
So it's true that what you're doing requires the mayor's agreement, and what he's doing requires your agreement. So if there is no agreement, that is still a possibility.
Say that again.
What you're doing requires his sign-off, and what he wants requires your sign-off. That's a possibility, or you were saying, I'm that's not a possibility, if you think about it, one way or another.
I, you know, the members of this council have consistently worked with people and worked together. And it's always our hope that we can come to a conclusion, which we did with the ABI issue. The earlier version of the ABI proposal, which was like a year ago, right?
Can I just make sure I'm clear? Did you say earlier you do have the support of all 16 other members for the plan?
With respect to the proposal?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So no one up there supports the $50 million bond?
It's $10 million
in, it's $10 million of debt service a year. In the 5-year plan, that's $50 million.
Do that face for us.
No. It's $50 million over 5 years. Why don't we borrow?
Yeah, it's, you know, I mean, you got a couple. You're solving a couple of problems here. I mean, you get rid of vacant real estate. You're putting it back on, in some cases, the tax rolls, and you're providing short-term money to the schools. I mean, I don't understand why people wouldn't be supportive of that. We didn't formally announce it.
Can I ask?
We're talking. I mean, he's supposed to say that. He said he's agnostic, right, on the revenue, the source. He just wants the money. I mean, if you guys had a $50 million plan to work, he'd say, thank you. I mean, that's, and I understand that. He's like, give me the money.
Councilman Kenny, and I believe Squilla have in the past, both accused the mayor of rejecting plans simply because they're not his plan. Do either of you think that's the case here? Could I have you at the podium?
Council President speaks for us all today.
Do you think that's the case here? Is he rejecting your plan because it's not his?
Well, interestingly enough, at some point during this conversation, it was our belief that there was a conversation about purchase of not only surplus real estate for disposition, but also bad liens. So that was a conversation that was had a couple of weeks ago that included the administration, included the school district. So, I mean, I don't know.
Plus, there's $123 million in outstanding taxes owed to the school district over the last 5 years to start collecting. Maybe we should get in here and start collecting some of that money.
Good. Thank you all very much. Thank you so much.